people, welcome back to my channel. Hola, bienvenida a mi canal. Salut les amis, bon retour sur ma chaîne. Konnichiwa, watashi no channel ni yokoso. I'm also excited by the sun today. That was my random comment for the day, but you know, it's okay.
Like, these days it was gloomy, it was dark, it was cloudy. It was actually really depressing, and now I can see the sun, I can feel the brightness, and I'm so excited by it. Yes. Anyhow, moving on. I hope you're doing fine. I hope you had an amazing beginning of the week, of course. If you haven't yet, please subscribe if you're new here. I do fashion-related videos twice a week, Tuesday and Thursday, 3 p.m. Eastern time. That never changes. You're gonna see me there like every week. I have a blog, I have a website, I have a digital lookbook. The lookbook just went out. I said that at the beginning of the week, but there were some delays. I'm really sorry about it. I have the link down below, but if you want to receive your digital lookbook magazine monthly to your box, definitely get back at me. Email address, I have my email address down below. So give me your email address and you're gonna have it every other month, and it's free for now, so you have nothing to lose but a lot to gain. I'm just saying. Today it was gonna be another chatty video because it's like sunny and I want to talk. I just wanted to have a really, you know, discussion with you guys. I mean, yeah, a really great closet detox for spring. Officially the time when you want to transition, you need to transition, you want to get rid of a lot of stuff and you want to buy a lot of stuff as well. That's my case, that's for sure. If you don't have enough space in your closet like me, you need to take a look at your closet and see really what you need to keep and what you need to get rid of, like for good. And these tips are also in my digital lookbooks. 6 main tips on how to like perform that great closet detox. Really helpful for you. Love being organized and love being structured. You still need to have that kind of bit of a structure, otherwise you're gonna get so much depressed, especially if you have a lot of stuff just like me. The first tip that I'm gonna have here is the most simple one. Well, it works for me. It's to be comfortable. Have a killer playlist. I'm not gonna stress that enough. I love music, I love listening to music, and I think all of us, well, we do like listening to music most of the time. Have to motivate as well. It depends on the kind of music. Cleaning, you know, it's gonna take you like literally hours to actually do it. So definitely have a killer playlist. All are different. I have a quite of favorites here. Songs are, and I have a lot of like relaxing music. So if you are more on the anxious side, I would definitely suggest you to have a playlist where it's like much more relaxing, because it's gonna help you to get rid of the stress and then start doing it in the better state of mind. It's not the one that I use the most because I'm using Spotify. I actually find the same type of playlist as well. You get a chance to do your own playlist, and then you get a chance to actually find some other playlists depending on what you're looking for. I think I'm more on the like beast mode, so find something like much more dancing, catchy, you know, it could be rock. Not even a joke.
I think you can change it, man. I'm playing with the majors. You can't make it, so you fake it.
Fune la fune. Way la fune. Mais c'était un poulet.
Come on, that's the point.
this girl? Who that be in that truck? Be my sorry. Who that be blowing gas at the Rari?
Like, the first thing that I go for is like African music, pop, and I listen to everything, actually, every single thing. As long as it's like sounds good to my ears, I'm just gonna listen to it. For me, I need something that moves, I need something dynamic, just because I'm like that. The day is just gonna be brighter, believe me. You're gonna see the end of it. It's not necessarily a nightmare, it could be like a nightmare at first, but believe me, you're gonna see the end of it. I have hopes. My second tip, after everything, well, lay everything out. I think everybody has that kind of luxury to have a lot of like space or room to actually be able to lay everything out. I have a tiny apartment, so I don't have a lot of space. Actually take pile by pile. If you, in my case, if you have the same issue that I have, it's gonna be much more easier for you to see the end of it. Not gonna have enough space to actually like put everything out in once. If you have the space for it, it's gonna be even great, because you have that kind of visual, like global visual, much more helpful for you to see actually everything that you have. The kind of person I will like accumulate like super super fast and super easily. I'm surprised myself by how much I have, and there are even some stuff I had. Something, it's special. Like, divide and conquer. Yes. Divide and conquer. Think about the strategy. If you want to get rid of it, put that in a pile. If you want to actually like, you're not sure yet what you want to do with it, keep that pile like aside, and then the rest that you really want to keep, keep that pile as well. But it's really, really, really important for you to actually be able to do piles, so that you can actually have the visual, okay, that I'm gonna get rid of, that I'm gonna just like see what I can do with it, or I'm just gonna sell it, depending. And that, for sure, I'm gonna keep it. So that it's gonna be much more easier for you to actually do what you need to do with this pile. Seeing visually how you can structure yourself and organize yourself. I'm all about organizing myself. Big, it's essential, it's vital, it's... yeah, it's me. So, the fourth thing that I'm gonna say that you can do next is to structure even better. And then I would say use boxes, because if you keep them in boxes, at least after that it's much more easier for you to just like bring them wherever you need to bring them. If you need to bring them to the Salvation Army, for example, you can do that in a much easier way, or you can use bags as well. But no matter what you do, you need to find a container, you need to find thing that you can use to actually like put them in. It's not gonna be on the floor, just laying around, you don't know what to do with it. Really, 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 really a good tip, really good step for me, for sure. Sit down and really think deeper, like what you wanna do with like each bag. It lets you know you're gonna get rid of. There are tons of options that you can do with it. Bring them to stores like H&M, Zara, they do collect like all stuff that you don't need anymore, they do collect it. And bring them to Salvation Army, for example, here in Canada. What I usually do is to bring them to church, do that as well. If they're still like really good condition and you don't want to just like throw them away, because it's like a really big waste. Just say, it's a really, really big waste. I think the other thing that you get, a swiping, like a clothing swiping. It was a so nice. It was my first time. Really, really, really cool, because you get to meet with your girlfriends and then they all bring their stuff that they don't need anymore or they want to get rid of, and there's which is in pretty good condition. You bring yours, exchange them, and it's like free, easy, and it's a so such a nice idea. I really recommend you girls, definitely think about it, because it's a really great option, because you don't need to buy any other items. All you need to do is just to do exchange here. By the way, this stuff was from the weekend. I was actually looking for a denim shirt and I was so happy to be able to find it. Think about it if you haven't done it before. I'm just saying. The other options that you have, you can sell them as well, because it's not, doesn't mean that because you don't want it anymore, somebody else doesn't want it either. Somebody else is gonna feel like super lucky to receive that. I never really sell them, I'd rather donate them or just give them away to my friends, but I don't like to sell it as much, but it's a great option as well. In Canada, well, you have Kijiji where you can do that. You have a Average Sale that where you can sell a lot of stuff, not only clothing. And you have Depop, but Depop doesn't work in Canada because I've heard a lot about it. But in UK, I know you can actually use Depop to actually sell back your clothes. So this is another great option, but everything is gonna be linked in the description box below for sure. The one that you really, really wanna keep, you need to think about it. Like myself, sometimes, again, I tend to like keep some clothes that I know, and I know that I'm not gonna wear that. For some reason, there's still a part of me that actually is convinced that I'm gonna wear it. And then there's that other side of me that actually telling us to get rid of it, but I'm still like, I don't want to get rid of it just yet. If you haven't worn your item for the past year, I'm sorry. You don't need it anymore. You just don't. No. 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 It's time to say adieu. It's time to say goodbye. It's time to say sayonara. It's time to say adios. It's time to say bye. Every single thing, and you thought about every single options, and you know what you want to do with your items, and you know what you want to keep, you know what you want to get rid of, what you want to donate, you know what you want to like give it away or just wipe it up with your friends. And to the next part, which is always a part for me, is to actually look for anything new for spring. And actually now you have a space, you have a room, and you have everything is like structured, organized. You know what you have, you know what you need, and now you know what you need to look for. Try to invest to anything related to jackets, leather jacket, shoes and bags. Even you still need your leather jacket because it's still a little bit cool. In summer you don't need it as much, but you need something to get to like fall. And then winter, of course, you need a coat and a jacket. For jacket, it's almost all the year round. This is something that you want to invest in. It's something where you just want to pay the price for it because it's gonna be one of the items that you're gonna like use the most. Also something that you can wear a lot of times. And spring, summer, you want to invest in some kind of pair of shoes that are not just trendy, because trends tend to just like fade away really quick. Something that you know you can wear the next year before having to buy anything else. Then buy a lot of basic. You can have a basic t-shirt, a really nice quality jacket, and that's gonna be nice. So tend to invest in like really nice pieces that's gonna go all the year around, and other basics, and buy them a lot more because they're not gonna be as pricey and they tend to just be in your closet as well for a while. When it comes to trendy, that's the part when you can actually like buy trendy, but don't invest in them because like I said, it's gonna fade away. What budget do you want to put, or are you willing to put in it? So I would say this is something that I would use as a guide for you when you want to renew your wardrobe. It's easy to get in the store like Zara and see all of the trendy things and look around and be like, my God, I want everything. I just want everything. I know what I'm talking about. Really easy to get lost and say, I want to buy everything. Just think about the strategy before even going to the store. That's what I would say. After that, you're pretty much done. You have your closet all cleaned up and you have new stuff, and at least you know now like globally what you have. So you know you don't miss anything and you know you don't need anything else. So you're pretty much set up for spring and summer. Of course. I really, really hope you liked it. My tips, and if you have any other common questions, of course, get back at me. I'm gonna be more than glad to answer your question. I'm gonna have a lot of things below. I'm gonna have digital magazine, a little bit like bigger, which I like. Have a couple of pages on what you need to get right now, what is like on a good budget, and what you need to get right now for spring and summer. I have a lot of things when it comes like hairstyles for spring, summer as well. I have, of course, a great outfit in spo, like for it. This is the best part for me. I love it. So I think the last part is like a gift for Mother's Day. We're getting there, we're getting closer to it, and I think it's the best part if you want to like please your mom. And we all love our moms. Well, I love mine. If you want to receive yours straight to your email box, get back at me. And of course, I'm gonna see you next week. And I wish you a happy, great weekend. Enjoy the sun, of course. Enjoy everything else. And of course, smile because it's free. Bye. Merci les amis d'avoir regardé ma vidéo, j'espère que vous avez adoré. C'était tout ce qui était en lien avec des astuces pour pouvoir refaire sa garde-robe. pour le printemps. Très bon guide en tout cas pour moi, parce que je trouve que ça m'aide beaucoup, parce que je suis quelqu'un qui a besoin de structure. Par rapport à tout ce que je fais en général, j'ai besoin d'avoir une structure, un plan pour savoir comment est-ce que je vais le faire. J'ai des astuces que j'utilise pour moi aussi, c'est sûr et certain, et qui en général marchent assez bien. Allez avec un pouce en haut si vous avez aimé, puis si vous avez des questions, définitivement n'hésitez pas. Mon magazine qui est prêt pour ce mois-ci, si vous avez besoin d'avoir ça directement dans votre boîte email, bah juste laissez-moi savoir, je vais le faire, ça va me faire plus que plaisir. Vous aurez la chance de pouvoir l'avoir sur une base mensuelle chaque début de mois et c'est gratuit, donc vous n'avez rien à perdre, tout à gagner. Bon, c'est juste en anglais. D'ici là, je vous souhaite un excellent week-end, amusez-vous, profitez de votre famille, de vos amis et tout ce qui va avec. Puis je vous vois la semaine prochaine, puis comme je le dis toujours, souriez parce que bah, c'est gratuit. Bye.